Hi everyone, this is Victor here. Welcome to the Intelligent Investor Channel. In this video, I'm going to analyze CME Group stock to see if it's one of the best dividend growth stocks. If you like to trade options and futures, you probably know that CME Group is one of the largest derivatives exchange in the world. Based on what I know, it's a near monopoly in the futures market. At the time of making this video, the S&P 500 index is still in a large correction because of the US Fed's aggressive rate increases to fight inflation. The S&P 500 is down around 16% from the most recent peak, and CME stock is down even more at 30% from the most recent peak. CME's forward dividend yield is at 4.84%, which is higher than most stocks' dividend yields. In this video, I'm going to talk about whether CME is one of the best dividend growth stocks. I will show you how to calculate CME stock's intrinsic value, so you know whether it's undervalued, fairly valued, or overvalued. You'll learn about these topics in this video. How does CME Group make money? CME Group's biggest competitive advantage. CME Group's biggest risk to consider. CME Group's long-term dividend growth trend. CME Group's stock valuation. And why buy CME Group stock? If you like this video, make sure to hit the like button, subscribe, and turn on the notification button. I will continue to make many excellent investing videos a week that will help you become a great investor. Also, if you like this channel and want to support it, check out my Patreon blog in the video description and become a premium member. Our goal is to create the best intelligent investor community that will help all our members grow their stock portfolios to over 7 figures over time. With your support, we will be able to stay independent and create many excellent stock analysis and investing videos a week that will help you become a great investor. The link is in the video description. Take a look, let's start. Before investing in any stocks, it's important to understand the company's business model and understand how it makes money first. CME Group is one of the largest derivatives exchange in the world for trading futures and options. Based on what I know, it's a near monopoly in the futures market, especially in trading interest rate futures and S&P 500 futures. Most traders trade on CME Exchange because of CME's derivative products and CME Exchange liquidity. CME Exchange allows investors and traders to trade futures, options, cash products, OTC products, and other derivative products in many asset classes in order to manage risk and to make profits from speculating on asset prices. CME Exchange allows investors and traders to trade futures and options in many different asset classes, including agricultural commodities, energy, stock indexes, forex, interest rates, metals, real estate, weather, and even crypto such as Bitcoin and Ether. CME also owns CME Clearing, which is one of the largest counterparty clearing houses for derivatives. CME earns revenues from two main sources, clearing and transaction fees, and market data and information services. Here's the important part. According to the latest financials here, you can see CME earns about 81% of its total revenues from clearing and transaction fees. This means CME's revenues are mainly dependent on the daily trading volume and average rate per contract every quarter. CME will benefit more when there's a lot of volatility in the market because CME will earn more clearing and transaction revenues from higher daily trading volume. When the equity market is very volatile, or when interest rates are changing quickly, or when the commodity prices are changing quickly, traders and financial institutions will trade more futures, options, and other derivative products on CME's exchanges in order to hedge risk and to make profits from speculating. For example, at the time of making this video, there is still a lot of volatility in the equity market and in the treasury market because inflation is still very high around the world. More importantly, the US Fed is planning to raise interest rates more and maintain restrictive policies for a longer period of time to fight inflation. This is why CME's average daily volume was higher in 2022. For example, CME's equity index products average daily volume grew 39% year over year, and interest rate products average daily volume grew 18% year over year in 2022. Again, this shows CME benefits more when volatility is higher in the market. When volatility is lower, CME will earn lower revenues and lower earnings because CME's average daily volume will also be lower. This from Seeking Alpha. It shows CME's long-term growth trend. In the past 10 years, you can see CME had fairly consistent revenue growth, operating income growth, earnings per share growth, and free cash flow growth over time. In terms of financials, CME has a very profitable business. For example, in the recent quarter here, CME had a 60% operating margin and a 55% net profit margin. Here's another important question. What are CME's biggest competitive advantage? According to Morningstar, CME Group has a large economic moat because its derivatives exchange is a dominant leader for trading US futures contracts and because it has very large network effects. Also, in the derivative exchange market, the barriers to entry are very high. CME Group has achieved a wide Morningstar economic moat rating as a result of its position as a leading venue for trading US futures contracts. More than 95% of US interest rate futures trade on the CME's exchange. The company has exclusive licenses to issue futures contracts on the S&P 500, Russell 2000, and Nasdaq indexes. And the company is the dominant venue for trading WTI oil futures. We see the company's strong competitive advantage allowing the firm to earn excess returns on capital for the foreseeable future. CME's position in the US futures market has proven durable as attempts by NYSE LIFFE and ELX to enter the US interest rate futures market failed to gain traction despite having contracts similar to CME's. This is because competition among futures exchange is largely dependent on implicit trading costs and collateral efficiencies, not the transaction fees the exchange charge themselves. For example, the minimum ticket size for CME 10-year treasury futures contracts is $15.625 per contract, compared with transaction fees that range from 30 cents to 75 cents. Even if another exchange charges less than CME, a one ticket size worst execution on even a fraction of contracts will wipe out any savings to the customer from lower transaction fees. This gives CME considerable pricing power and has allowed the firm to enjoy an operating margin that has historically been around 60%. Here's the important part that talks about CME exchange liquidity. The ability to trade on exchange efficiently is dependent on the amount of liquidity present on the exchange already. This creates powerful network effects as the number of traders that already utilize CME exchange ensures that its contracts have good liquidity, increasing their value to other customers. A potential competitor would need to attract a critical mass of trading volume before it could offer its customers comparable execution to CME. A difficult prospect as its initial user base would need to be willing to accept higher trading costs during the startup process. This process would be even further complicated by CME's model as a vertically integrated clearinghouse and the restrictiveness of futures contracts. Contracts purchased at CME's exchange cannot be closed at another exchange and vice versa. This keeps CME's liquidity pools captive to its exchange and creates additional barriers to potential competitors. The firm's clearinghouse also benefits from network effects. If one of CME's customers failed to settle a contract, the exchange would step in and close out the transaction after sizing the collateral of the defaulted counterparty. Any potential losses by the counterparty are covered by a waterfall structure in which CME first covers the losses up to a certain amount. After CME's contribution hit their limit, any remaining shortfall is then covered by a guarantee fund paid for by the clearinghouse members or direct assessments on the clearinghouse members. This substantially reduces the systematic risk for investors and helps attract additional trading volume to exchange. Additionally, it's more efficient for collateral purposes for clearinghouse members to participate in as few clearinghouses as possible. This discourages the introduction of new clearinghouses as a new entrant provides little risk mitigation to its members until it can establish a user base. This adds additional challenge for a new exchange to enter the market using the same vertically integrated model clearinghouse model as CME. CME's clearinghouse is another competitive advantage that cannot be easily copied by other competitors. As far as I know, there are very few counterparty clearinghouses CCP for derivatives. I think one of the biggest reasons that counterparty clearinghouses are heavily regulated by regulators is very hard for new competitors to start their own clearinghouse, build a trusted brand, and build a very large customer base. According to the 2021 annual report, CME is designated as a systematically important financial market utility and a systematically important derivatives clearing organization by CFTC. This shows how important CME is in the derivatives exchange market, especially in the US. Here's another competitive advantage. CME owns 27% of S&P Dow Jones indices. S&P Dow Jones indices owns the S&P 500 index and many other related indexes. S&P Global Inc. owns the remaining 73%. By owning 27% of S&P Dow Jones indices, CME has exclusive rights to creating futures, options, and other derivative products based on the S&P 500 and other related indexes. Also, the more people invest in the S&P 500, the more licensing fees CME will earn every quarter. For example, if you look at this financial here, you can see CME has non-operating income from unconsolidated subsidiaries each quarter. A large portion of this non-operating income is from S&P Dow Jones indices every quarter. In my opinion, I believe CME's biggest risk is much lower daily trading volume when there's less volatility in the market. CME benefits the most when interest rates are high, when the equity market is very volatile, or when there's a lot of volatility in forex and commodity markets. This is because traders and large institutions tend to trade more options, futures, and other derivative products to hedge risk and to make profits from trading when there's a lot of volatility in the market. For example, at the time of making this video, the US inflation has started slowing down from the most recent peak, but it's still far above the 2% inflation target. The Fed is planning to raise rates more to ease inflation, even if it will increase the unemployment rates and likely cause the US to head into a recession in the upcoming months. The war in Ukraine is still ongoing. Many central banks around the world are still raising rates and tightening their policies to fight inflation. Also, China is still facing thousands of COVID-19 cases every day. All these macro headwinds tend to benefit CME because they tend to create more volatility across many asset classes. However, when volatility is lower, we can expect CME's daily trading volume will also be lower. Over the next several years, when the market is back to normal again with lower volatility, I believe CME's average daily volume will likely slow down to single-digit growth instead of double-digit growth. For example, in 2022, CME's equity index products' average daily volume increased 39% year-over-year. Interest rate products' average daily volume grew 18% year-over-year. Forex exchange products' average daily volume increased 24% year-over-year. In a normal market when there's less volatility, CME's average daily volume should grow at single digits instead of double digits. Another biggest risk is that CME's average rate per contract has decreased slightly for several quarters already. This may continue going forward if CME wants to increase daily trading volume. Let's talk about CME's long-term growth and expected dividend yields. Going forward, I believe volatility in the market, especially interest rates and equity index, will eventually normalize because the US inflation has already peaked and it's decreasing gradually almost every month. Also, the Fed will eventually pivot and lower interest rates again once the US inflation is near the 2% target. To be more conservative, I think CME will also have single-digit revenue growth rates going forward because the current market is no longer as volatile as in 2022 when the Fed started raising rates aggressively, which of course impacted many asset prices. According to Seeking Alpha, CME's annual revenue is expected to grow 7.1% year-over-year in 2022. Going forward, CME's annual revenue is expected to grow at much lower rates over the next several years. I think this assumes market volatility will be lower going forward. Also, CME's earnings per share are expected to grow 19% in 2022. But going forward, CME's earnings per share are expected to grow at much lower rates over the next few years. In terms of dividend growth, CME pays a regular dividend every quarter, plus an annual variable dividend that depends on CME's earnings and free cash flow each year. If you look at CME's dividend history here, you can see CME's annual variable dividend change every year. For example, at the time of making this video, CME paid a regular dividend of $1 per share for the past 4 quarters. Then in January, CME paid an annual variable dividend of $4.50 per share. This means CME's regular dividend yield is around 2.26%. And if we include CME's annual variable dividend, CME's dividend yield is around 4.84%. Here's the important part you will need to consider if you're a dividend growth investor. When interest rates are high, you will need to compare dividend growth stocks to other principal protected investments, such as CDS. CDS are one of the safest investments. They are principal protected and are almost risk-free. The biggest risk is inflation risk. If CD rates are around 4 to 5% each year, and a dividend growth stock's dividend yield is around 4 to 5% each year, then it probably makes sense to just buy CDS because they are principal protected. Personally, in most cases, I would still invest in dividend growth stocks if the company has strong fundamentals, great management, a large economic moat, increasing revenues and earnings, increasing free cash flows, and increasing dividends over time. Also, I will only invest in the company if the stock is undervalued to reduce risk. However, if CD rates are higher than, let's say, 5% each year, I would consider buying CDS that pay high interest. But again, the downside is that CDS do not protect against inflation. Now, I want to show you how to calculate CME's intrinsic value here, so you know when CME stock becomes overvalued, fairly valued, or undervalued now. If you want this calculator, you can download it from my Patreon blog in the video description. These are the key assumptions in this calculator. First, I define CME's intrinsic value as its future free cash flows discounted to present day. The discount rate is 9.5%. You can use a hard discount rate here if you want to be more conservative. CME's most recent trailing 12 months of free cash flow is $2.65 billion. You can update this number here whenever CME releases new earnings. Based on the risk and the long-term prospects I talked about earlier, I believe CME's free cash flow will grow at a compound annual growth rate CAGR between 4% and 6% each year over the next 5 years. I think this growth rate is reasonable, assuming market volatility will be lower going forward. Let's go over these three case scenarios here: worst case, normal case, and best case scenarios. Under the worst case scenario, we're assuming CME's free cash flow will grow at a CAGR of 4% over the next 5 years. If we forecast CME's free cash flow over the next 5 years and discount the free cash flow to the present day, CME's intrinsic value should be around $66 billion for the entire company, or $184 per share. I'm giving this scenario a 25% probability here. Under the normal case scenario, we're assuming CME's free cash flow will grow at a CAGR of 5% over the next 5 years. Then CME's intrinsic value should be around $69 billion for the entire company, or $193 per share. I'm giving this scenario a 50% probability here. Under the best case scenario, we're assuming CME's free cash flow will grow at a CAGR of 6% over the next 5 years. Then CME's intrinsic value should be around $73 billion for the entire company, or $202 per share. I'm giving this scenario a 25% probability here. If we add all these numbers here, CME's intrinsic value should be around $193 per share. I also use this price to book valuation method to estimate CME's intrinsic value, which should be around $199 per share. If we take the average here, CME's intrinsic value should be approximately $196 per share. In comparison, Morningstar estimated CME's intrinsic value to be higher at $215 per share. This means I believe CME is undervalued at the time of making this video. So will I buy CME Group stock? Yes, I will likely buy CME stock going forward because I like CME's business model and its large economic moat in the derivatives exchange market. Personally, I will only buy CME stock for the long term when it's at least 10% below its intrinsic value, so there's enough margin of safety to reduce risk. Now, all these are only my opinions and my analysis based on my research. They are not financial advice. There are always risks associated with investing. You will need to do your own research and do your extra due diligence first before investing in anything. Thank you for watching this video and supporting our channel. This is Victor from the Intelligent Investor channel, and I will see you in the next video.